23-year-old Dong Fengpeng is legal intern working at a law firm in Fengtai District, Beijing. As a rookie who started his career only 2 years ago, he's beyond busy with not only his daily tasks, but also voluntary consulting services.
在这个我们律所工作的过程中，日常我会去一些社区之外呢，我还会跟随我的职业律师，去一些比如仲裁啊，或者是工会啊，然后残联这些地方去做一个公益的法律服务，也是一个咨询类的这个工作。一般来说，我一个月会去5到6个社区，然后一个月每次是去一次，时间大概就是2到3小时。As
an apprentice lawyer, Dong still needs some support for his consulting work. He needs the guidance of a practicing lawyer.
因为我们社区的服务量也是比较大的，然后职业律师可能就是会带一个实习律师去社区进行一定的咨询，然后也会分配一些简单的咨询给实习律师，就是说让他们也了解一下案件的各种类型，然后我们在旁边也会做一定的指导。在赠与合同中，或者是在继承那个遗嘱之中。
The workload at the community continues to increase as people become more aware of how the law can help them solve problems in their daily lives. Most residents come for a consultation about issues with property, housing, or marriage.
原本是5、6个人，现在已经是每天去了以后10多个人都在排队咨询。那么可能我们为了解答大家的问题，就会更详细一些。我们可能就不得已要去加一些时长，甚至之后要去拉群啊也好，或者是加微信也好，再去线上再去抽时间给大家解答。There
are many reasons behind the dramatic change. The internet has provided a main platform for promoting the legal awareness among the general public.
也好弄，其实。
诉状啥的可以直接就从网上找个模板，然后大概写一写。就是立案程序上面，现在我们也是简化了很多了。现在当事人可以直接从微信上、小程序里，或者是咱们的那个电子诉讼平台上面都可以进行立案。包括现在法院，其实他们也有一些那种自动生成诉状的机制。这些简单的案件，可能不需要你再一笔一笔划去写这个诉状，可能你在里边输入你的相关信息或者你的一些基本的事实情况，就能给你生成一份完整的诉状。
Rule of law helps solve the people's problems, and when it becomes easier to access, more are willing to make use of legal services.
大家能解决问题了，这个是最关键的。那么我的一个问题得到一个很好的解决，那么我之后再遇到这样的问题，我可以向我身边的人去推荐，说我这个事儿你应该怎么去处理，或者是我应该怎么去处理。那大家都有这么一个意识了，那肯定是在之后的维权过程中会相信我们的法律是有意义的，而且相信我们的法治建设是有效的。
China still has improvements to make in its legal development. The legal awareness of the Chinese people is growing along with its progress, just as legal intern Dong Fengpeng is improving as he helps more and more people. Hou Na, CGTN, Beijing.